Anterior laterally there is a uretric openings are there, ridges are there, then these are the, between these two ridges there is a dominant, there is a prominent ridge is called interuretric ridge. Well, it can be seen through an instrument called as cystoscopy. Well, now we will go to the capacity. Can look over. Capacity of the urinary bladder. Are they? Capacity of the urinary bladder, we can see here. What is the capacity? Usually the 220 cc. 220 cc is the normal. 220 cc is usually the normal capacity. But it varies from 120 to 120 to 320 cc. 320 cc. And we feel by 320 cc, we feel to desire for micturition. 320 cc, we feel desire for micturition. But at the level of when it goes 500 cc, we feel painful. We start painful. The referred pain in the anterior abdominal wall. Referred pain in the anterior abdominal wall. Anterior abdominal wall, then the penis, anterior abdominal wall, the painful is there, there is a 500 cc, there is a, beyond this, there is a micturition occurs, there is a 500 cc, anterior abdominal wall, penis and perineum, there is a referred pain start here. If the capacity is more than 500 cc, there is a pain start here, referred pain start here in the anterior abdominal wall, penis and the perineal region. It is the capacity of the bladder. Now we will go to the applied anatomy. Sorry, blood supply. Blood supply. Blood supply is the superior vesicle. Superior vesicle. Inferior vesicle. Superior vesicle. Inferior vesicle. From the anterior branch of internal iliac artery. Anterior branch of internal iliac artery, additional branch. Additional branch is from the pudendal artery. From the pudendal artery, obturator artery. Blood supply, superior vesicle, inferior vesicle. Both are branch from the anterior branch of internal iliac artery, additionally pudendal artery, obturator artery. In the female from uterine and vaginal. Uterine and vaginal. It is the blood supply. Now we'll go to the penis damage. Penis damage. That is the inferior, that is from the penis drainage, that is from the fascial plexus, fascial venous plexus, fascial venous plexus, drain into internal iliac vein, internal iliac vein, pass along with the lateral ligament. Lateral true ligament or lateral ligament. That is the lateral ligament. Then the lymphatic drainage. Sorry, posterior ligament. That is the venous, lateral venous from the posterior ligament. Sorry, posterior ligament. Now we will go to the lymphatic drainage. Lymphatic drainage from the internal iliac. Internal iliac lymph nodes, some directly from lateral, some directly from para-aortic or external, some directly from lateral aortic, lateral para-aortic. Lymphatic drainage in the internal iliac lymph node. Some are directly from lateral para-aortic lymph node. Lymphatic drainage, internal iliac lymph node. Then some drain directly to the para-aortic lymph node. Now we'll go to the nerve supply. Nerve supply is very important. Nerve supply is very important clinically to the clinician, to the urosurgeon, that is from the fascial plexus. Fascial plexus from inferior hypogastric plexus, then into inferior hypogastric plexus. Here it has got sympathetic parasympathetic and parasympathetic, that is the TL1 to L2. It is S2, 3, 4. Sympathetic and parasympathetic, that is the sympathetic is inhibitor, sympathetic is the inhibitor to detrusor muscle, and motor to sphincter. See here, this both sympathetic and parasympathetic are working vice versa. Sympathetic nerve is the inhibitor to detrusor muscle and motor to the sphincter of the urinary bladder. But it is agonist, parasympathetic goes totally dead opposite. It is motor to the parasympathetic is motor to the detrusor, inhibitor to the sphincter. Both are working vice versa, both are working in a opposite direction. Both are working in a opposite direction. Now there is a, apart from this, there is a somatic nerve supply. There is a somatic nerve supply, that is the pudendal nerve. Somatic is the pudendal nerve. Somatic is the pudendal nerve, that is the S2, 3, 4, which keeps the urine, which voluntarily holds the urine. It voluntarily holds the urine. Pudendal nerve, somatic nerves voluntarily hold the urine. Now the sensory, the pain sensation, sensory. Now the sensory nerve are, what are the sensory nerve are? Sympathetic, parasympathetic. Sympathetic, parasympathetic plus lateral spinothalamic tract. Lateral spinothalamic tract. Lateral spinothalamic tract, lactothalamic tract. This causes awareness of the urinary bladder distension. These three factors, sympathetic, parasympathetic, lactospinothalamic tract, causes the awareness of the, this causes awareness of the urinary bladder distension. Whenever the urinary bladder gets distension, it causes awareness. Then, well, lateral parathalamic tract of the posterior spinal cord. It is regarding the nerve supply, sympathetic, parasympathetic, then the pudendal nerve, sensory nerves plus lateral spinothalamic tract. Lateral spinothalamic tract. Now the last but not least, that is the applied anatomy. Applied anatomy. Last but not least, applied anatomy. Whenever there is a rupture occurs, if the rupture occurs, there is a chances of, whenever there is injury to the lower abdomen, whenever there is injury to the lower abdomen, the rupture of full bladder may occur. Injury to the lower abdominal wall, rupture may occur. Rupture of the urinary bladder may occur. The peritoneum may involve or may not involve. But the, when the bladder is, when there is an injury to the lower abdominal wall, if the bladder is full, the urinary bladder more prone for injury. Now number two, that is the, see the, due to the enlargement of the prostate. See here, you can see the prostate here. Here also you can see the prostate, where the neck is here. When the prostate enlarges in the olden age, whenever there is enlargement of the prostate, here you can see, here also you can see here, prostate is enlarged in the olden age. That is called as BEP. Benign enlargement of prostate. When the prostate enlarges, there may be the constriction. There causes a constriction of the urethra. Constriction of the internal urethra will occur. It causes incontinence. There is a sphincter of urethra. It leads to hypertrophy of the urinary bladder. Hypertrophy of the urinary bladder. It causes hydroureter hydronephrosis. I repeat it. In the olden age, there is an enlargement of the prostate, is called BEP. Benign enlargement of the prostate. When the prostate enlarges, the internal sphincter is constricted. It leads to hypertrophy of the urinary bladder. It causes the hydroureter and hydronephrosis. And the instrument we can see. The internal structure, I already told you, that is the cystoscopy. Cystoscopy is an instrument who can see the internal structure of the urinary bladder. Then, the urinary incontinence. Emptying of the bladder. Is due to the reflex action. Is the reflex action of the motor pathway and sensory pathway. The sensory related to the upper motor neuron. Voluntary control. The voluntary control is upper motor neuron. And the motor is the lower motor neuron. And these are the sensory. Sensory is the lower motor neuron. sensor is the lower motor neuron, and voluntary control is due to the upper motor neuron. Please rectify this. Sensor is due to the lower motor neuron function, and voluntary control is the upper motor neuron control. Now the lesion in the both pyramidal tract. See any lesion in the pyramidal tract. That is the and the lesion of the spinal cord. Lesion in the spinal cord leads to voluntary inhibition and voluntary initiation. I repeat, see, there is a lesion in the pyramidal tract. Lesion in the pyramidal tract at the level in the spinal cord leads to the there is inhibition, voluntary inhibition of the passing urine. Voluntary initiation of the passing of the urine will occur. Then there is a in the tapus dorsalis, you know, sensory cord, sensory lesion, sensory part of the spinal cord is called, that is a tapus dorsalis, sensory loss of the spinal cord. It leads to atonic bladder. Sensory loss of the tapus dorsalis, atonic bladder. The person will not be knowing how much urine, the collection of the urine is unknown to it. The collection of the urine is not known to him. That is called as the reflex. There is no reflex contraction. Atonic bladder is there. Now the dribbling of the lesion in the sympathetic pathway. Dribbling, sympathetic pathway, and there is a sympathetic nerve supply, and there is a paralysis of the sphincter. Dribbling of urine is there is a problem, lesion in the sympathetic nerve supply, and that leads to the paralysis of the sphincter of the urinary bladder. It causes dribbling of the urine. The retention of urine will occur. Urine will retention. Lastly, that's the retention of urine. That is the due to the non-functioning of the parasympathetic, overaction of sympathetic. I repeat it. Retention of urine will occur. There is the parasympathetic and sympathetic. There is no action. The parasympathetic is not acting. There is a lesion in the parasympathetic. There is a impaired function of the parasympathetic. The parasympathetic is not functioning properly. But overaction of sympathetic, it leads to retention of urine. These are the retention. Dribbling we have seen. Atonic bladder we have seen. But developmentally there is ectopia fasciata. Ectopia fasciata means the anterior part of the lower abdomen is not developed. Anterior part of the lower abdominal wall is not developed. Anterior part of the urinary bladder is not developed. Pelvic bones are also not developed. It is called congenital anomaly, called as ectopia fasciata is a congenital anomaly. Ectopia. Ectopia fasciata is the congenital anomaly where the lower part of the abdomen is not developed. And lastly, I will see developmentally. Do you remember trigone is from the mesonephric duct? And remaining part is endodermal origin. Mesodermal part means developmentally it is dual in origin. The trigone of the bladder is mesodermal. Remaining part is endodermal. It is very much important to know. And nerve supply is very much important to know. Any doubts are there, do call me. Don't hesitate to call me. Please take care. All the best.